Dearborn, Michigan, a suburb of Detroit, is home to one of the largest concentration of Muslims in America. It is here that Imam Faisal Rauf began the eight-city national tour that he hopes will build interfaith understanding.
Well, what we need now is a discourse about Islam and Muslims in America. Our role right now is to depoliticize our faith.
After the 9/11, some of the American people understood Islam as a religion of terrorists.
Being descendants of slaves who were Muslims and who weren't Muslims, being African American, I shouldn't, once again, have to feel apologetic about if I want to walk down the street with a thobe or if I have my wife and she has a scarf on. There is no reason for me to be apologetic. Islam is a beautiful religion that incorporates all different types of races and nationalities and backgrounds.
The purpose of my visit is to reach out to the American community, both the Muslim and the members of other faith communities, to explain to the American public why the issues surrounding it are very important. The issues of religion, the issues of how America as a country that was founded for freedom of religion must stay true to its own principles. Also, how America as a nation wants to integrate with its own 7 to 10 million American Islamic community that is equally American and equally Islamic and well integrated not only with the broad society of the United States, but also to integrate it in a more effective way with the more than 1 billion Muslims worldwide, in which America has a very important engagement, a very large footprint, and many, many shared interests.
Well, I have been in the United States since 1976, so I've been here for a long time. I can say I'm proud to be a Muslim, and at the same time, I am very proud to be an American. This is where I made my family. I have 6 children who were all born here, raised in America. I have a dentist, I have a lawyer, I have an IT son, and I have other children whom we hope to raise on the same footings in the hope we contribute as we. Before becoming an imam, I was an engineer.
You know, America has this long history of racial tensions and trouble with ethnic groups and races. And I think Muslims, we can provide a very unique contribution if we do have these discussions within ourselves. And then, you know, we can show the greater American public that it is possible to have this type of unity.
Many aspects of what we think to be uniquely Islamic things are actually part of the general immigrant story. Even today in New York City, there's a Chinatown. And yet the Chinese are integrated all over America. Little Italy, as we call it in New York, that's part of the fabric of society. But Italians have expanded and have integrated. It's an ongoing story. It is not just one part. People come, they stay in one place, but then their descendants and children's children, over a period of 2-3 generations, a whole community integrates itself. And in a place like Detroit, you can see how 3-4 generations of Muslims have come, have lived, have defined themselves, but have educated their children, and their children have integrated themselves better with the broader American social fabric. We have to respect each other. It's fundamentally about that. So you get to know more about me and my faith, and we too have to learn more about your faith. Since 9/11, I have dedicated the rest of my years to working to bring a much better relationship between the country that I love and the faith that I love.